Hi, this is Steve Kafka again. We're in Phoenix. It's 115 degrees out, and I'm about to stripe a very oddly painted El Camino. It's a custom mixed color. It's kind of an opaque pastel lime green and silver. It's two-tone. The fellow's name is Ed Williams, very nice gentleman from Sun City, and he's put a budget of $500 into the stripe job. I'm quoting prices because I want people to have some realism on what this costs. It's very hot in the shop. We have evaporative cooling, but I mixed a whole bunch of colors to go on this thing. I hope you find it as interesting as I did doing it.
Well, I'm starting the center line on the hood. This hood comes to a peak, and if you've ever done this, it's like a tightrope walking. Lately, I've been doing some old school mixed in with my stuff, and kind of resembles it. So I start out like that a lot of times. I'm applying the black first. Using my number 3 scroller. The temperature's probably about 104 degrees in the shop. And the humidity is high for Phoenix. Pretty much done whining. Get that old school point in there. Right, just put some my scroll stuff to complete the design and tie the two styles in. Yeah, there's that done. Now these are the sides. The deep pillars. You can see the old school tie in. Alright, this out. I'm setting it up to take more color. There's that green. First time you're seeing that green that I was talking about. Gave me some problems. Obviously not the black, but these altered colors, I ended up, we got a shot of it. About 10 color cups. Just to get some greens that we can turn color on. He was instrumental in actually mixing the colors. And what I'm doing is just looking, glancing my left eye at what I've got going on the other side, and lip loops are in conjunction with the left side. Right. It's the old school looking stuff. It's kind of fun. I mean, not kind of fun. This is, I love what I'm doing. I'm going to outline this later with another shade. I was originally going to use silver, but I was kind of changing as I was going because different colors didn't work out with it. It's kind of a pale lime green. Really, really unusual color. The separation line on this car also is a little palette here. The separation line on this car was just absolutely perfect, so I left it alone. Paramount lining with the same color. brushes off with so much control. Now you have to mix your paint a little bit differently. Pretty hot temperatures with a lot of humidity. I didn't loosen it up a whole lot, but here's the tie-in with the scrolls. This swung around just with the second color. Doing the outline on the centerpiece. People that have been watching me for a number of years that hadn't seen anything video-wise in 6 years, I think, they were saying that they saw a new twist, and they're very complimentary. So, heartwarming. Just got new lights in the shop, but all we have is evaporative cooling. It's miserable. Just in August, the rest of the year it's pretty good. The outline of the centerpiece is also very reminiscent of old school striping. Doing a combo. Both the different styles. If you haven't tried this, it's real easy to get involved in. It's just so much fun. I have quite a few of these videos up. And here's a color that when I put it on the silver, it looked very, very close to the base color of the car, the bottom color. But then when I used it on the bottom color, it looked like olive drab. And then which works. I mean, it's not what I had expected, so. But it works, especially with that teal looking color there. And as you know, anything looks good on silver. But, I mixed some more color too, and got to be tan. So, it was very surprising. Third color. I'm just adding a little weight to the outside. Just some more outline to enhance that black, makes it fall. You can see how nice that brake line is in this shot. Between the two colors, it was perfect. I like this color transition a lot. Now we're going lighter. This is just out of the blue on next. This is a straight process, but it has a really cool effect on the other colors. Ties it all together. And those of you that do my style, you'll notice I make subtle changes. It's because it's an always evolving style. This is way different than the stuff I was doing 10 years ago.